Alright guys, welcome back. This is probably one of our best hands yet, and I came to my attention that I recorded the last two matches with my webcam microphone rather than my actual microphone, so I apologize for the audio quality on those. Hopefully you guys are still with us, and you can hear the updated audio quality, which is what you should come to expect. But welcome to Modern Monday, and this is round three. I'm going to keep this hand because it's fantastic, and we're going to make a colorless mana and play an Aether Vial on turn one. Then we can play this guy for free and a Battle Singer. Not to be confused with Marla Singer, who is from Fight Club. They're not the same. If we Kabir Evangeline give them Pro Black, are the Queen of Protection from Living End? Oh, this is not Living End. This is Death Shadow. D Shadow, if you will. Alright, so they took a Street Wraith. Once you play an ally encampment, the jig is pretty much up, right? Like, they're like, oh, we know what's going on. You're not fooling anybody, the old ally. Oh, Grimflayer. Interesting. I am intrigued. So, what color land do we get? Let's go Wooded Foothills and get a forest. Do we play Undo Cleric, How to Free Blade? Do we play How to Free Blade, Undo Cleric? I think we play How to Free Blade, Undo Cleric. We're definitely playing this guy, that's for sure. The question is it Undo Cleric to pump this guy? Is it a Battle Singer to pump this guy? How relevant is our life total here? And do we just want to attack? I think we actually just want to attack with the Battle Singer. Boom. And to be fair, they can actually like Lightning Bolt or Hot of Free Blade and then Grimflayer. Give it Delirium, I guess. That's the thing. I mean, they could have done that anyway, though. There's no, like, we can't really stop that. We are surprisingly close to a Windswept Heath. So, that, or not a... that doesn't make any sense. To a Collected Company. So, we'll see if that's a thing that we are able to... Oh, God, Collected Company just feels so good when you... They're at 6? Bro, my deck is so aggro. Alright, you almost have Delirium. If you Lightning Bolt this guy, then you do have Delirium. Got a Grimflayer. So your hand is Street Wraith Grimflayer. That seems fine. I don't actually think I care about that. You don't get to draw cards. You go to 4. If we block and you do have Lightning Bolt, you Lightning Bolt our Battle Singer and you get a 2-for-1 and... you get to, So yeah, Lightning Bolt will give you Delirium. So you actually, if you or like Abrupt Decay, any instant would give you Delirium. So you actually kill our Battle Singer. Yep, yeah, so you have the Lightning Bolt. So that's fine, we take 4. Then we have Battle Singer on board. That seems pretty good. We know you have Street Wraith Grimflayer in hand. Can we kill you? Probably not. But... we can certainly try. Yes. Alright. 2/2 drops is pretty good. This guy. Oh, I just hit a thing underneath the desk, so. I'm sorry. That's already. Always yes. Always yield. Let's attack here. Paying costs. Lightning Bolt. We'll play Undo Cleric in response so that we gain more life. It's totally fine. We know they have 2 cards. One's a Grimflayer, one's a Street Wraith, so I'm not terribly concerned. Thank you. I mean, Kabir Evangel's fantastic here. If they play Grim Flayer, we just go pro. What do you call it? Green black, I guess. Yeah, no blocks. I will go to 14. Feel comfortable about it. Actually, they might have put the Street Wraith in the graveyard. I don't know, because this Grim Flayer is super weird. Like, watch their graveyard. When they put cards from Grim Flayer into the graveyard, they don't go on the bottom. Like, where I don't know where that card went. Everything just moved. Now there's a Grim Flayer up here and a forest down here. It's super weird. I have no idea why it does it in the order it does, but it makes it really hard to track what goes in the graveyard. A land. A Grim Flayer. Let's get a red mana of some sort. Probably a Sacred Foundry. That seems fine. No. Can you imagine if we draw land and then we have Aether Vial on 3 for Kabir Evangel? That's kind of like a land, I guess. It might just kill you, though. So. Black. Kill you? That seems good, right? And dead. Alright, the aggressive deck is pretty sweet against the deck that tries to kill themselves. Seems good. Alright. So Natural State we don't care about. Spellskite we don't really care about. Relic might be reasonable. Rest in Peace might be better. Rest in Peace is good against Tarmogoyf. I'm gonna bring that in. Take Expedition Envoy out again. Path also could be very good. We can bring in a Path here. Take out one Beast Caller Savant for another Path, because their creatures are usually pretty big. I like that. I don't really care about Relic that much. He says now. I mean, we can probably go around Tarmogoyfs is my belief. Maybe Relic is better than Rest. I don't know. I just don't like having to worry about... this hand is fantastic. We're going to keep it. Captain's Claws. Stardate. That's from Star Trek. Except they don't say Captain's Claws, they say Captain's Log. It's similar, though. It's similar but different, you know? Misha's Bauble. Disconnect. I'm out. Forget it. I didn't expect to be drawing this stupid card. Alright, we'll pause it till they get back. Okay, they're back. They played a Verdant Catacombs. Now they get to draw their little crad. Oh, let's name... That is a land. That's pretty nice. Let's name Ally. I had a Free Blade once. That's one of the oldest jokes in the book. Alright. This guy dead? Are you gonna lightning bolt this guy like immediately? Wow. No? Yes. Okay. Super aggro. Harabest Druid into Collected Company is also pretty good. And we can collect, we can Captain's Claws. Here comes the old Grim Flayer. Oh, 4/5 Tarmogoyf, that's a big dude. Remember that time we put Paths in the deck? Yeah, this is why. This poor Harabaz Druid. Can't do anything on its own. Don't kill it. Oh, no! That's so good. That's so sad. If they attack, we're just going to Captain's Claws. That seems actually reasonable. Don't kill my guy, though. Oh my god, what's going on now? Wow, Dismember? How did you get this rude? They are at 10. We're still winning the life race, which is kind of cool, I guess. Always yes, always yield. Alright. And now you have Lightning Bolt too? This is... Nope, no. Do you have it? What do you... have another Dismember? Oh, alright, sure. Just infinite removal here. Alright. Dismember, Thoughtseize, a Lightning Bolt, Fatal Push, and one Tarmogoyf to hold down the fort. They might not have anything else. Everything else might stick. Unfortunately, we don't have any one drops with haste, and two drop can't Captain's Claws here, so let's get a Stomping Ground. Oh, Blade Master. Not terribly. Can Blade Master go the distance? That's the question. We only have a forest left, so we're gonna get that. Seems alright. If we can get Collected Company, could be good. Can they just draw blanks is the question. Just draw some blanks. Put you on Lightning Bolt. I'm just not gonna do it. I need a guy on board if I want to get anywhere, so I'm just gonna take 5 and go to 3 and hope to dodge Lightning Bolt. They're thinking of attacking, so they clearly don't have a Lightning Bolt, which is great for us. I don't think they have a removal spell either, otherwise you just, like, turn this guy sideways and kill our guy, and then it's not even a question. But being at 7, when we have things like Akum Battle Singer, oh, alright, we will take it. We do have to draw a guy here, though. Oh my goodness! Let's talk about how good that was. I don't think you have it. Oh my god, more triggers. You're dead. Whoa, this is amazing. Alright, we'll see you guys in round 3. Why are you playing this deck in Modern? It's fantastic. Oh.